and what is the use of time travel. So these are the cloud part we are going to discuss it. Okay. So Python, the fundamental level thing we'll be going to discuss it. How to install the Python as well as the pip packages and data drives, collections, string slicing, iterator and control statements and functions, how to create the own function, lambda functions, as well as some class concept and pandas. Because pandas is very important for your data engineering platform. If supposed to work with the data science, you must learn about NumPy also. That is also one of the important. Okay, so before going to discuss in detail session, the cost I'm going to discuss with you. Already you know the syllabus as well as the cost. Okay, here I just declare all the cost depends on your two options you want to pay. That's it. And the payment will be in 3-4, you can pay. The cost is little different. So while you're joining, you want to pay just 1,000 rupees. And after 1 month, you can completely practice, but we will not be sharing any materials. You can understand the session, how it's going on, how our classes are very relevant to your topics and all. Something like you can go through with that. After 1 month, you can pay whatever the first installment. If supposed to select for full stack developer, 12,500 will come. So already 1,000 rupees you paid. So 11,500 only you want to pay. Okay, completely 1 month, we will not be asking you. This is also refundable if you are not satisfied. You will not be asked any questions. If you are not interested after 1 month, we will refund your 100,000 rupees. Because your confidence as well as your interest is very important, because based on that only we can give some assignments and all, right? You'll be interested in doing that. We don't like to forcing you. It depends on your interest and your own thought. You can come. Okay. So this is the way you want to pay it. And second month, you can pay the balance. Okay, so 12,500 something, right? That you want to pay. Because you want to know the sessions as well as your understanding and our quality, everything you want to monitor it. That is the reason we will not be forcing you just to pay 1,000 rupees and attend the sessions. Okay. Quality is very important, so that we just plan to discuss in this paper. Any question? Yeah, timing, the same time. Six PM to 3 PM IST weekend. Okay, and language, this batch completely English. Okay. Any other question?
I have one question.
Yeah, please.
So how we are going to start? I see like in syllabus we have mentioned like Hadoop and after that Hive and all. But coming to the setup part, like in Docker container, multi-node cluster also we were discussing, right? So Docker also, are we going to see in a depth?
Yeah, definitely. Because Docker also is one of the session, right? But this is completely scripting, just we can execute. So you don't worry about it. Just you want to install the Docker desktop. We tried to go with Kubernetes, but we have some challenges with the multiple source environment. It's supposed to work with Windows with the Windows 8 OS as well as Windows 10. So there is some differences. I can see that. So we cannot complete in Acura, so that we cannot include Kubernetes still. But Docker is possible to install all our machines, I'm sure. I have tested that part. So you can install the Docker desktop or in your Linux platform, you can install your Docker and directly you can use it. We just tested our shell script and it's working fine. Even though if any trouble with our Docker, we have alternative with virtual machine. That is also we can provide. So there is separate virtual machine is available. So this is also we can give you. Depends on your system performance and your system integrations. We can use any one of them. We can give you the both and you can use it. Okay, we have both. For Tamil batch, we can start after 2 weeks or 3 weeks, but it will be in the morning time. Your session is going on and based on the people interest, we can, and based on the nomination as well. Because last time we have received very less nominations. So it depends on the people interest, we can create a separate batch. Anyway, the quality is very important. If you are not understood, you can repeatedly ask me, even a chat or direct voice. You can discuss it. And materials, if you missed the sessions and all, we have a Google Drive that we will be storing all the information. Okay, we will give you the Google Drive access and we will be storing all the your recordings, everything will be stored, you can use it. So sometimes the sample I can give you, Hadoop, AWS, Docker, Snowflake, everything, we can create a separate folder and we'll give the access particularly. So here the recording is available, all the recordings. So once the session is over within 24 hours, we're trying to push it here. As well as the class notes, whatever we are going to discuss in practice, right? At the time, the commands, materials, the codes, everything we can share you, you can use it. And if we are going to use any paints, at one time we are going to demonstrate the particular sessions, right? All the paints details will be shared. And few assignment inputs. Okay, something like we can give it. So if you are missing the session or you cannot join at the time, you can refer this your recording and you can complete your assignments. Okay. So these three, four things, recordings, as well as class notes, assignments, and some common drive available. Old recordings, that old sessions, whatever we have, right? So that information we can fold into common drive. So here the common current PM, that information, some sample data set, other recordings, some old topics is available, scope, what else? Scope HP, something is available, right? So that are also old topics that we can hold it here. You know, worst case, you don't have any other references, you can use it. Because nowadays, a few of the old tools nobody is using. So, but it is very famous in the previous time. And unfortunately, you're going to work with any one projects with the old framework, then you can refer it and you can practice it. And library is available, you can refer all your libraries. there are all the books is available, almost 4,000 books is available. You can use it for work. Additional references. Okay.
Sir, I have one doubt.
Yeah, please.
Big data with Azure is preferable or big data with AWS?
It depends on your opportunity and your pipeline. That's the reason we will not be forcing you to mention what is your option. Sorry, what you want to select something. We just give you all the options. So if you have a good opportunity with Azure, you don't have any references, then you can definitely learn about Azure one day. Right, so it depends on your opportunity and your practice. If you are becoming an MSBA developer right now and you want to move on, then Azure is the best way. If you are an Informatica, AWS.
Okay.
So some combination system. But if you are more than 8 years or 10 years experience, you want to be an architect. You want to know all the full stack, right?
Okay.
Because you are an architect in the future, you want to know how the tools is work. Okay.
So we'll see all the data pipeline creation and all also, yes, in Azure.
Yes, we will be going to create the service and we can go into interact with Python programming, right? So how it's going to be communicate via programming, and because in real time also you're going to use some programming API only. Same, we are going to practice it and we can explain all of the properties, what it is available in the particular services, and then we can use it for our sample. Some testing, some data set, right? We can use it. And finally, we can terminate it. All this functionality, you're going to see it. Okay. Python programming training. After Hive is over, we are going to discuss about Python. Python is over, then only Spark is going to start. If everyone know about Python very well, then it's fine. Directly, we can start with Spark. If somebody is not good with Python, then we will be take the session for Python at least 5 hours. Once they get the confidence, then we can move. Because in this session, tech and non-tech, as well as freshers, everybody will be joined. So we have to balance everyone. That's the reason we will be include the Python without skipping. It's additional, but even though that's fine, but you want to learn the program, then you can confidently enter into the programming platform. Okay. Any other question? Anything else? Yeah, the VM is available. You can use this VM in case you cannot use the Docker. We are planning to completely go with the Docker, but if you have any trouble, you can use this PM. This is a single node, standalone. But Docker is going to be act as a multi-node. That's the only difference. And everything predefined and installed. But you want to meet the reality, then Docker multi-node cluster will give you. You're supposed to create any Hive tables. And you don't worry about Docker. We will make everything automatic scripting. You just want to run the script and start. That's it. Okay. The same question. Two, both of them is running, right? Let me kill it. At the same time, VM as well as a Docker, we cannot use the reserved memory. It will take some. Okay, any other question?
Sir, can you explain the short introductions of this pipeline for the Azure with the big data? How the data flow will be with Azure?
Azure, you may be using any blob storages, right?
Yes.
So that blob storage, how it is working, how to create the blob storage, how to use it, As well as, you know, based on the block tree, we have data lake concept, gen 1, gen 2, two things are available. That's what we are going to discuss, how to load the data and how we can implement the data. And the virtual machines, as well as SD Insight cluster is available. So SD Insight based, how we are going to interact with the block, as well as our data lake storage informations. These are the way to discuss it. Okay. And Cosmos DB. Cosmos DB, we are going to use Cassandra API or MongoDB API is available. We are going to inspect new ones. But mostly we prefer to go with Cassandra API because Cassandra also is a part of your session. So we prefer to interact with Cassandra API. Okay. And there's some sample SQL databases available, how it is working. And then I would have it even done. Yeah.
In Azure, the cluster creation will be done with the HD Insight cluster, right?
Yeah. Here we are going to create a cluster. It's a multi-node cluster. The same practice only we are planning to provide in the Docker. But this is the Azure base. This is our local. That's it. That's the difference.
Okay. Docker is a local base, huh?
Yeah, we are going to create all the containers over here.
Okay.
Okay. That's the only difference. And IoTR, we even tell how to streaming your data. That's what you're going to discuss by IoTR and how you're streaming the data. So you can create the pipeline with Eventer. These are what you're going to discuss. Here, Genesis is available. Genesis data streams, how it is worth. Okay. Normal Kafka, you're going to practice with our cluster via Docker integrations. Okay, we'll go with detailed syllabus, the course material, everything I just mentioned. At last, we'll give you some final interview sample questions and we can give you the answer. And we will inform you for some time until that you don't attend any interviews. You want to concentrate and complete all the assignments. In a certain time, we can inform you to go for the interview and you can attend the interview and bring all your questions. During that our session, our last 15 minutes, we are going to one day discuss about your interview questions, if you have. Because they will ask different questions. You don't have a proper answer. We are trying to help you to solve it. Then only next time, if you go for the interview, you can bring it up from other questions. That questions also will be tagged it for future references. And Hadoop, what we are going to discuss here, Hadoop the basics, how the Hadoop is working, name, node, data, and all the demons, we are going to discuss it. And we are going to run some sample MapReduce program via Hadoop, how it is responded properly. Thus, we are going to discuss it. This is a completely Hadoop 3x version we plan it to discuss. And some places I noticed still they are using 2x version. So we can discuss how 3x is working as well as 2x. What is the difference? These are also we are going to discuss it. And this was Hadoop only. Hive. Hive is majorly used all the corporate. So we are going to discuss in detail with even Hive environment, how to work with Hive metastores and how the pipeline engine is created, the architecture pipeline flow, and what is Beeline, Hive CLI, how it is working, and what is Swift server, and how to create the table for managed table and external table, what is the difference, and creating multiple tables with the different data set using Avro, Pocket, ORC, and what is JSON, and some complex data type data, everything we are going to practice. And partitioning, types of partitioning, like as dynamic and static partitioning, and bucketing concept, and third implementations, Hive joins, and some complex data. This is already in info. And top 10 performance tuning, relevance to even interview basis, and we are going to see everything in practice. So this is first 15 minutes. This is we're going to complete maximum one session because some architecture, how Hive is working, this is all we are going to discuss it. After that, everything we are going to discuss via practical one. Okay. Any question?
No, sir.
Mostly we will be covered here, all the importance with the Hive environment. And then Python is over. We are going to start with the Spark. Spark is almost 70%. They are asking Spark only in interviews. So 30% they may be go with Hive and other tools. So 70, 60 to 70% we can ask it. Only relevance to Spark they are going to ask it. So that we will be going to discuss all the combinations in Spark. How Spark is working with the local standalone mode, as well as the YARN cluster mode, client mode, as well as normal local. So these are what we are going to discuss, and we are going to go in detail with RDT transformation actions and narrow transmission, wide transformation, a lot of things is available that we are going to discuss, and how to convert your RDD to data frame operations and multiple data frames, how to create it, and multiple data frame readers and writers, we are going to discuss it. In after that, data frame transformations are available. There are also some narrow and wide transformations available. So we will be going to discuss the most important transformation, repeatedly what are we are going to use it, everything we are going to discuss it. And creating the JDBC read and write operations, and read the data from OWASP bucket, everything is a common, right? So data frame reader will be combined here. All this we are going to see with real-time practice. And performance related, sorry, okay, JDBC, Hive table, and some other pocket files, other files with Hadoop environment. Mostly these three you are going to work with in real time. Or some places you are going to interact with some streaming, right? That is the next. Okay, so JDBC, pocket, data from files, and JSON. So these are also combinations you are going to see. And this is the one batch project you're going to see. It's a kind of batch project via Spark, you're going to practice it. So this is the combination with any one of them, Hive or some JDBC connection, you're going to use it and create and practice it with real time some project flow. After batch project is over, then streaming is going to start. In streaming, okay, before streaming, we are going to discuss about cache and persistence of concept, as well as a Spark SQL and Spark SQL transformations, and Spark streaming. Spark streaming also DStreams is available, as well as structured streaming, both we are going to see. And then Kafka Spark integration, and how to submit the jobs via local, client, cluster, everything we are going to see. So this is Kafka Spark integration. We'll start after the Kafka is over, because you want to understand the Kafka properly, then only you can understand how Spark is react with your Kafka. So that we will be going to complete a Spark KSQL. After that, we just switch into Kafka. We'll be covered everything with Kafka and come back here and go forward with the Spark Kafka integrations. Okay, this is the way we are going to approach it. And then performance tuning, what are the ways the performance tuning you are going to approach it? So all the discussions we are going to see with practical. It's not nothing in theory, everything in practical. How to see the experiment plan, how to use this broadcast joins, collapse, repartitions, and the cache and persistence, and the shuffle partitions, implementations, everything you're going to see with the real time. And so based on the streaming project, we are going to cover it. Okay. So hope everything will be covered in Spark. Nothing we missed it, right? Anything you noticed? Any question in Spark? Any doubts? Okay, great. So Kafka, how the Kafka is working, we'll be using Confluent Kafka as well as normal Kafka, both we are going to see it, because we are planning to discuss with the Docker, right? So Docker, we have separate Confluent Kafka is available. That is also we are going to integrate, because in real time also they are using enterprise Confluent Kafka. That is also we are going to discuss it here, how it is work. What is the difference between normal Kafka and Confluent Kafka? And then all the information with Kafka implementations, how to create the broker, and what is the replications, partitions, and how to create the consumer groups, everything we are going to see it in here. Okay. So creating the topics in replica, what is follower, leader, and what is the poll interval. Most of the information we will be going to discuss with Kafka. Once Kafka is over, this Kafka and Spark, this both will be the same projects. Okay, so because it's a streaming, it's a combination. We will be coming together and we'll see that some projects go. Mostly we'll be going to get the data from LinkedIn, Twitter, some live real-time data. We are going to take it up and we'll show you. I have 3 years of experience in Linux admin. I want to switch my career to big data engineering, basic knowledge of Python and MySQL. Is it possible to switch? Yeah, possible, definitely. Because we already have some experience in Linux, right? Big data platform, Linux is some basics. So if you know the Python as well as some SQL concept, you can easily switch over. I'm sure. But you want to put some effort. How much you're interested, whatever we will be giving some assignment, right? If you're going to do that, then you'll get some idea. Even though if you go for the interview, you cannot clear, you just bring the questions, we will help you definitely. And 3 years experience, definitely a lot of openings available. A lot of openings available, people are very less nowadays, to be honest, I'm saying. So this is a great time if you're clear and say if you complete the trainings and you will be go for the interview. It's the current time that MSA is going up. Even our team also, we'll be looking for multiple people, but we'll not be getting it. So a lot of additions happening. So try to study and get ready for the new interview. Okay, so Docker. Why we will not be mentioning the Docker in the first one? You may be confused. Docker is additional. If you go and practice with your data engineering platform, Docker is a basic. Some places you may be use it, some places you will not be touch it. So it's a relevance to DevOps platform, but you must understand how Docker is working, that's fine. Because in the future, you may be doing some deployment, right? At the time, via Kubernetes, you're going to do that. There you maybe have some knowledge with the Docker. So we will kickstart with the basics of Docker, how the Docker is working, what are the commands is available, how we can use the Docker. That definitely will help you for future practice. So how to create the container and port forwarding, and you create your own containers, images. So multiple images available, Docker commands is there. Everything you're going to practice, volume creation, network creations, and to create the Docker file with your custom build images, everything you can do. Because some places you want to create your own image. Based on that only you can react. So everything we are going to give it. Okay, it's mostly Docker relevance to image creation, container, volume, networking. This four only. Okay, any question? Okay, fine. In Cassandra, how Cassandra is working? Here also, multi-node cluster, Cassandra only we are going to use it. So how to create multi-node cluster, sorry, multi-nodes with data centers in Cassandra, how we are going to use it? Everything we'll be going to save it, multi-node only. Nothing in standalone, single node. We need support with your desktop, your system, laptop, that's it. If you have proper support with your system, then it's fine. All we will be create and will give you, you can practice it. Not a standard. Okay, that only we will be requested because we just developed everything, but it should be adapted with your system. That's very important. So how to create this Cassandra tables and how we can use the key spaces and create this replication strategy with the different strategies available, everything we are going to see it. And how we are going to interact the data via Python as well as the PySpark. These are we are going to discuss with Cassandra. And then Airflow. Airflow, how the web server, scheduler, task instances, and this downstream, upstream integration, executors is available, Spark, Hive, and some other executors available, some sensors is available, everything we are going to discuss it. And data profiling and other queries, operators, sensors, these are we are going to discuss. And we will create a scheduling manner, and we can see with real time. So runtime, your Hadoop cluster is going to be run it, right? At last, you're going to schedule it. This job is going to be interact with your YARN and deploy your job automatically via Airflow. So all the connections and connectivity, everything will be going to practice it. Okay. So that's it. After Airflow, then already I mentioned AWS Azure. So AWS, Azure, and Snowflake will be coming. Okay. And it depends on, we will not be forcing you. Few of them only select for, AWS, that's fine. Few of them only select for Azure, that is also fine. It depends on. Until Hadoop basics, you will get the data engineering platform, you will get some jobs. But it depends on your experience, you want to choose this. Because only fresher is not required to go with cloud in detail. But if you have more than 3 years experience, you must know about any one of the cloud. More than 8 years, you must understand all the cloud services because you have opportunity to go with management, manager levels. Maybe there you want to do this kind of pipeline integration with the architecture. Okay, so instructor background. So I just introduced myself, I'm Dinesh. I have 10 plus years of experience. And 11, just reached 11, I'm sorry. Okay, so around 5 years relevance. Okay, Big Data platform, I'm almost working with 5 years. And I'm Cloudera certified. Azure. GCP. Google professional certification is available. Professional data engineer. That certification also available. This is major. Right now is without expert I have. Okay, other certification I have done, that's not important, relevant to our Big Data platforms. I am mostly taking all your sessions, and the other two trainers available, they have 10 years of experience. And they are going to integrate with cloud platforms. Mostly AWS, Azure, and Snowflake. Okay. So additional two trainer maximum. So maximum 2 to 3 members. Mostly Big Data platforms and Azure, Snowflake, this all I will be covering myself. AWS, this cloud platform, maybe other trainer will come. Okay. Freshers can take a career as data engineer. That would be a great opportunity because data engineering is an evergreen platform. You may be survive all the time. Because other platform, I'm not sure. Definitely in a business, you need a data. Data is a kind of new oil now. So data engineering is a good platform to compare with other, and cost, the salary, everything you know very well, data engineering, they will get much. And after data engineering, you may be try with the data science. Data science also relevant to data only, but you need some more exposure. That's it, and try. Can you please explore how was career in Big Data Engineer with 3 years of experience, how much CTC we can expect? So in this question, I cannot answer directly, but I can give you some inputs. So whatever you're getting the current CTC into 2.5 or 3, you can get it. I'm not sure what is your current CTC. So in the current time, the people are trying to give this hike with the 2.5 or 3x. So 3 times maximum you will get it. I know very well one of the guy, just 3 years of experience, he just placed in visa and he is getting 70 lakh, I'm sure, 1.7. So I'm not sure, depends on your CTC into 2.5 to 3x or some places 2 to 3x. The range will come here. If you go with more than 8 years, 2x they will give you. If you can go with the cloud-based companies. It's not like that. Cloud-based company is not like that. Okay, you know, depends on that your MNC. They will be planning to move forward with any one of the cloud. If you are a fresher, cloud is not much important. They will go through with, because you will be going to hire as a trainee or intern, something only. So they will give you some additional references. But if you have experience, you must know any one of the cloud. Even a 2 to 3 years experience, you must know at least one cloud platform. That's very important. So in a MNC, we cannot assure they will be going to use only for AWS, Azure, or GCP. They will be using the combinations. Okay. How much experience you have? Sorry, somebody is texting me in private. So they will be mentioning there is CTC also. Yeah, you'll get 2x definitely, I'm sure. Okay. Any questions? Any other questions? Mostly we will be discussing this point. We will not be missed anything.
Hi, Dinesh. Sorry, Jordan, a little bit late, but I have a question. Do we cover any data warehousing related to this big data cloud, stuff?
Cloud data warehousing is a Snowflake. Separately, okay. AWS Redshift is available, but it's a dependent, right? So we don't like to go with only AWS Azure, so that we just include Snowflake. Snowflake is a completely cloud data warehousing.
Okay, yeah, got it. Thanks. Mm-hmm.
Because some companies, they need, because real-time practice, Redshift is a part, as well as Azure also, they're using their own cloud data warehousing. But integrations and improvements, they will not be doing that. But Snowflake is doing by weekly manner. That's the reason Snowflake, we have a lot of openings. And our syllabus will be changed, depends on the recent trending. What is the current trending? That is, we are going to mention as a syllabus. That's the way we just prefer it. Okay, every 6 months, we just go through with the current trend with our company, what's their record. Everything we'll be going to collect. Based on that, we'll be create the syllabus. Already I informed, our session is completely interview basis. So what kind of question they may be asked in this particular tool, everything we are going to see with practical. Then you'll get the confidence, you can explain in visual manner to them. Okay.
Yeah, thanks, Dinesh.
Yeah. Anything else? So if you are interested, you want to join, while joining the session, the next week, the same Saturday and Sunday, 6 p.m. that is going to start. You just pay 1,000 rupees. You just text me in private WhatsApp. This is my WhatsApp number. If you're interested, you can provide it. And please fill your details in your nomination form. Based on that only, we can give you all the access in the future. Just to fill the nomination form, only you can just pay 1,000 rupees and join 1 month completely. After 1 month only, you can pay your rest of the payment. Even if you are not satisfied within the 1 month, you can refund your 1,000 rupees without any questions. Okay, I'm sure. I promise you. Okay. Anything else? I think nobody is giving you this way, because we need some confidence from your end. That's very, very important. Without dilemma, you want to reach to us and adapt with us, then only whatever we are giving the training, right, you can easily apply. That's very important.
Dinesh, maybe probably share some previous batch results so that it will be more motivating for the participants.
Oh, I'm not sure. Anybody's joined here? Guys? I'm sorry, nobody's joined. Because I don't like to disturb them. Okay. No.
I was asking, like, you can, if you have any anything to show on results of previous batch, you can explain them.
So yeah, they, few of them, actually, the people are joined from US, they will be placed in big companies as well. And only one guy is joined in Facebook, I'm proudly inform him. Others, they will be placed US and India, all the companies. And our previous members who have joined, right? They are working with Ernst & Young, Bank of America, and PayPal, L&T, and Accenture. These are all the common companies available. And US, mostly the people are joining. Because this is timing, they're requested from the US funding. So they'll be joining and they'll be informers. I joined this company, something like that. I can share the text. Whatever they'll be mentioning in the WhatsApp, right? I can share in my profile picture. You can refer to what they have texted. And still they are in touch. We almost covered this many batches. So separate. They will be bringing their own project use cases. That is also we will be supported. Okay. And we had offline location also in Chennai, but now it's closed due to this pandemic. We just closed it. After it's open, we'll be going to start with offline institution also. Okay.
Yeah. Thanks, Sebastian.
And people are getting 2 to 3 expansion. Last, I know very well, one of the guys joining CloudRock in US. That's the last result I have received from them.
So they don't have a prior big data experience, right?
Yeah, they don't have. He's come from testing development, testing support.
Okay.
He just moved to big data platform and he just noticed all the interview questions and I asked him in the middle of our sessions. We'll be explaining to them what kind of answer we have to provide to them, something like, and some POC he has bring it up. We just help him and clear the interview and place it. Okay.
Great.
That's the reason the quality is very important. You don't want to trust me. I don't like, okay? You can understand how the session is going on. You just feel it. And then you can come to me. That's very important.
Right.
Hadoop admin is not kind of role right now, I'm sure, because previous to Hadoop admin, there is a separate role is there, but nowadays they are merged with DevOps platforms. Because Hadoop admin platform, everything will be taken care of with cloud platform directly. So just a plug and play, you can do infra as a code, everything they will be developed in. So no, not a separate Hadoop admin is available. They will be interact with the DevOps nowadays. So if you are good with the Hadoop admin or admin role, DevOps is the best options. Okay. And I'm not sure how long that DevOps, what all things is available. Kubernetes integrations and Terraform, something is available. That is also a trending market. I'm just trying to give some hints. And if anybody is having some security platform, try to interact and learn about cybersecurity as well. That is also a very important thing, but not good trainers are available in India, I'm sure. But a lot of openings is available, I can remember. Recently, December middle, Log4j vulnerabilities happened. At the time, a lot of the issues have arisen. Yeah, if you are a fresher, we will cover Python programming from the scratch to intermediate. Definitely, but we will be covered the Python programming from the scratch, right? We will be going to use some IDE. So PyCharm, Jupyter Notebook, and VS Code. This three IDE, we are going to use it and do all the codes we will give you. And we will share some assignments you want to do it from your end. Once you know the programming, then only Spark you can enter it. So after the programming session, then only Spark is going to start, and we are going to do all the coding in Spark development. So you don't worry about it. That's the reason we will not skip the programming. We just include it. Okay. Any other question?
So what is the process? Do you evaluate assignments, Anish?
Each topics we are going to cover it, right? After that, we are giving some basic assignments to bit advanced. So that's capable to complete your end. Otherwise, we will help to complete that also.
Okay. So it will be evaluated from your end as well, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
We will give you some timeline. Before that, if you are completed, that will be great. Otherwise, we will give you some solutions. First, we will try to give you some clue, and then only we will give you the solutions. Okay. Because Hadoop basics is over, we're going to practice with some apps, right? So same, because you have environment, you want to do only the practice. And a session will start exactly 6:05, we'll be going to start. 5 minutes maximum, we can wait for the people. Even a single member is joined, we can start, we will not be wait for any of them. So try to join on time. Once the session is started, you can update. And we will create a separate WhatsApp group once you joined. Okay. So there we will be mentioning all the bridge informations after the paid session. First 1 month, we will not be doing anything. If you're joined with the payment, we will create a separate paid batch, and we will give you all the material access, everything to you. But you want to observe how the session is going on, you can attend the live session, but you will not be sharing any materials. Total month of training will go around 3 to 4 months. Okay. Sometimes 5 months also this will happen. Anything else? Any question?
If you're going with the Azure Databricks will be covered.
Azure Databricks. No. Azure Databricks. Databricks is a separate, right? Separate tool system. We have previous recording. We can share you that. We can refer it. At the 2 years back, Databricks is not famous that much, but nowadays it's famous. So we have previous recording, right? That we will share you. In the future, we can include with Databricks also. So future, we maybe go with the cloud Kubernetes integration or GCP. Once GCP or any, all the cloud will be combined, then Databricks also additionally we plan to include. That's the future. Okay.
Okay.
So some this is references how I was working. Let me go into create the database. Okay, the internal taping will be right. Okay. Just as a starter, MapReduce is going to start in the back end. Or you can mount it. So in some statement, MapReduce program is just started. So you can see the regressions. Okay, it's done. Yeah, job success. So we cannot see the logs. So the MapReduce, Spark, Engine, and what is test 3 we can see here. So Spark also we can read. Okay. So something like we're going to use the terminal only mostly. So everything will be combined. And separately, we have Jupyter Notebook. How to use the Jupyter Notebook and all we'll be going to discuss in real-time session. Mostly while the internet is Hive or Spark, right? There we'll be about it. Okay. Any other question? And separate on queues we just create for dev as well as a prod separate because it's mostly close to real time. It's not real time, it's close to real time. How they will be creating the two clusters separate for dev and prod, how they will be going to use it in real time integrations, everything we are going to practice it. Okay. Yeah, I hope everything we discussed today, nothing is missed. Yeah, so payments. Okay, and one more thing. In the future, if you are going to any new tools be introduced, like Kubernetes or GCP, whatever I mentioned, right? If supposed to join that particular tool services only, then you want to pay only 2,000 to 3,000, that's it. You don't want to pay everything, just the particular payment. That's a minimal payment only. You have to pay and join. Because in the future, something will be in trend and we are going to add it. As an old student, we will give you this additional this thing. Okay, everything we discussed. So if you have any questions, you can ask me, I'll try to answer. It's your time. Any question? Are any doubts? I'm happy to answer your questions. And you can text me in chat. Okay. Tamil sessions, I'm not sure. depends on the nomination. That is the option in nomination form I just mentioned. You can choose it. If you are flexible with Tamil, you can choose that one. Based on the nominations only, I can take the Tamil sessions. Because most of them come for English only. So very less nomination I have received for Tamil sessions. So that's the reason I cannot confirm it. If I receive the proper Tamil session, that's the number of people I have received, I can give. Yeah, ma'am, any question? Hello. Amar, any question? Okay. Any other question? And limitation of batch maximum 15 members. We will not be add multiple members here because oral joint, we need to monitor them and give you at least good quality. Maximum 15 members was restricted for each batch. Yeah, duration of the complete course will reach from 3 to 5 months. Okay. So it'll reach 4 to 5 months, I can say. Anything else?
No, Dinesh.
Okay, guys. We'll see you next week at the same time. For us, join, interested, just text me in WhatsApp and fill the nomination form. Okay.
Thanks, Dinesh.
Yeah. Thank you, everyone.
Thanks.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, Krishna, please go ahead. We have discussed almost everything. So if you have any question, you can ask me. Or you can refer the recording. We will share it in our channel. You can refer. Yeah, please.
Okay. So in Azure, what are the topics we are going to discuss?
You just refer the syllabus. You will hear all everything you mentioned. Blob storage, Azure data like Gen1, Gen2, virtual machine, SD inside clusters, Cosmos DB, SQL databases, IoT Hub event. Okay.
Okay. Commonly, what we called all these services are going to be, what is the role kind of in data engineering?
If you are full stack means we will be going to work with any cloud and in big data platforms. Okay, that's a full stack engineer nowadays, they will be available. But if you are only preferred to go with Azure data engineer separately, that AWS something like, and cloud data engineer, they will be going to interact with all the clouds.
Okay.
After the data engineering, data science platform, they will be using ML engineer and applied ML on the ML data science engineer, something like this available. Yeah.
Okay. This course is 3 to 4 months, right?
3 to 5 months depends on the people understanding.
How will be the market after May or June kind of thing?
Definitely, this time is a good one. Because a lot of openings is there, but people not available.
Right now, the market is good. This month, market is good.
Mm. Definitely, next 2 years, I'm sure the market should be in good money. Because the problem is, freshers is very less nowadays. Okay? Nobody is going for the college and they have not been doing anything, right? So the people are afraid to hire the freshers mostly some places. If you have a good knowledge, then it's fine. Okay. Otherwise, it will be trouble. So for less freshers and more projects is available. So the people are trying to adopt their own experienced candidates. Nobody is planning to release their own employees. Even if you put the paper, they are trying to pay you 100% or 50% high, and they will be holding you. This is happening nowadays. So next 2 years, no problem, I'm sure. After that, I'm not sure.
Okay.
Anything
okay.
else?
Okay. I'll talk to you personally about
my sure.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Any other question? Okay, fine. Okay, thank you then. Let me close the session today. Bye everyone. Bye Arif. Bye Abdullah. Bye Suresh.
Bye sir.